Hey, we are in Numbers chapter 17 and 18. We're still seeing some struggling people. The Israelites really aren't liking being told what to do. They want to be in charge. They don't want to be in the wilderness. They want to have their homes, place to live in their own towns. And they're just kind of being knuckleheads about stuff and not trusting God. And so God again is going to reveal who he wants calling the shots and why he wants calling the shots, them to call the shots. So let's go ahead and jump into chapter 17. The Lord told Moses, call together the 12 tribes of Israel and tell the leader of each tribe to write his name on the walking stick he carries as a symbol of his authority. Make sure Aaron's name is written on the one from the Levi tribe, then collect all the sticks. Place these sticks in the tent right in front of the sacred chest where I appear to you. I will then choose a man to be my priest, and his stick will sprout. After that happens, I won't have to listen to any more complaints about you. Moses told the people what the Lord had commanded, and they gave him the walking sticks from the 12 tribal leaders, including Aaron's from the Levi tribe. Moses took them and placed them in the Lord's sacred tent. The next day, when Moses went to the tent, flowers and almonds were already growing on Aaron's stick. Moses brought the 12 sticks out of the tent and showed them to the people. Each of the leaders found his own and took it. But the Lord told Moses, put Aaron's stick back. Let it stay near the sacred chest as a warning to anyone who might think about rebelling. If these people don't stop their grumbling about me, I will wipe them out. Moses did as he was told. The Israelites cried out to Moses, we are done for and doomed if we even get near the sacred tent. The Lord said to Aaron, you and your sons and other Levites of the Kohath clan are responsible for what happens at the sacred tent, and you and your sons will be responsible for what the priests do. The Levites are your relatives and are here to help you in your service at the tent. You must see that they perform their duties, but if they go near any of the sacred objects or the altar, all of you will die. No one else is allowed to take care of the sacred tent or do anything connected with it. Follow these instructions so I won't become angry and punish the Israelites again. I alone chose the Levites from all the other tribes to belong to me, and I have given them to you as your helpers. But only you and your sons can serve as priests at the altar and in the most holy place. Your work as priests is a gift from me, and anyone else who tries to do that work must be put to death. The Lord said to Aaron, I have put you in charge of the sacred gifts and sacrifices that the Israelites bring to me, and now from now on, you and your sons and your descendants will receive part of the sacrifices for sin, as well as part of the grain sacrifices and the sacrifices to make things right. Your share of these sacrifices will be the parts not burned on the altar. Since these things are sacred, they must be eaten near the sacred tent, but only men are allowed to eat them. You will also receive part of the special gifts and offerings that the Israelites bring to me. Any member of your family who is clean and acceptable for worship can eat these things. For example, when the Israelites bring me the first batches of oil, wine, and grain, you can have the best parts of those gifts and the first part of the crops from your fields and vineyards also belong to you. The people will offer this to me. Then anyone in your family who is clean may have some of it. Everything in Israel that has been completely dedicated to me will now belong to you. The firstborn son in every Israelite family, as well as the firstborn males of their flocks and herds, belong to me. But a firstborn son and every firstborn donkey must be bought back from me. The price for a firstborn son who is at least 1 month old will be 5 pieces of silver, weighed according to the official standards. However, all firstborn cattle, sheep, and goats belong to me and cannot be bought back. Splatter their blood on the altar and send their fat up in smoke so I can smell it and be pleased. You are allowed to eat the meat of those animals just as you can eat the choice ribs and the hind leg of the special sacrifices. From now on, the sacred offerings that the Israelites give to me will belong to you, your sons, and your daughters. This is my promise to you and your descendants. It will never change. You will not receive any land in Israel as your own. I am the Lord, and I will give you whatever you need. 10% of the Israelites' crops and one out of every 10 of their newborn animals belong to me. But I am giving all of this to the Levites as their pay for the work they do at the sacred tent. They are the only ones allowed to work at the tent, and they must not let anyone else come near it. Those who do must be put to death, and the Levites will be punished. This law will never change. Since the Levites won't be given any land in Israel as their own, they will be given the crops and newborn animals that the Israelites offer to me. The Lord told Moses to say to the Levites, when you receive from the people of Israel 10% of their crops and newborn animals, you must offer a tenth of that to me. Just as the Israelites give me part of their grain and wine, you must set aside part of what you receive as an offering to me. The amount must then be given to Aaron. So the best of what you receive will be mine. After you have dedicated the best parts to me, and you can eat the rest, just as the Israelites eat part of their grain and wine after offering them to me. Your share may be eaten anywhere by anyone in your family, because it is your pay for working at the sacred tent. You won't be punished for eating it as long as you have already offered the best parts to me. The gifts and sacrifices brought by the people must remain sacred, and if you eat any part of them before they are offered to me, you will be put to death. And so we see, again, God giving some guidance to the priests. But again, we see the acts of rebellion. Behind me is inscriptions into the cathedral at the Cathedral d'Amiens in France. This was done in the early 1200s. I think this cathedral, it took 20 years from 1220 to 1240 to be built. And it's called the Aaron and his blossoming rod. You see it right there. And so that God could show who was in charge again to these people. There are always going to be knuckleheads out there that want to be in charge and who are not worthy to be in charge. Our best role is to trust God and to follow his guidings and his leadings to us as we make choices and we live our life. I hope you have a great day.